So today in this lab we will explore one data set that is very important, and we are doing it with linear regression only, and this is very easy. So to answer the question, if we can accurately predict stock price over a time, I'm going to use stock price history data from this is a Quidel API जहाँ से कि आपको स्टॉक प्राइस का डाटा सेट मिल जाता है. सो बेसिकली इफ़ यू आर प्रिडिक्टिंग अ स्टॉक प्राइस अर्लियर, ऑल्दो विच इज़ अनप्रिडिक्टेबल, आई एम बिकॉज यू नो इट इज़ ऑल मार्केट बेस्ड एंड ऑल आर सिचुएशनल बेस्ड. सो बट स्टिल इफ यू कैन प्रिडिक्ट द स्टॉक प्राइस दैट इज़ यू बट दस यू नो वी हैव सेवरल सॉफ्टवेयर ऑल्सो विच कैन प्रिडिक्ट द सॉफ्ट द स्टॉक प्राइस ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ यू नो द ट्रेंड वट इज़ गोइंग ऑन, एंड दे विल प्रिडिक्ट इट फॉर अनदर 4 to 5 seconds और यू मे से द 20 seconds. That what is the next move for the that particular stock, but the range is very small, you know, for another 20 second or 10 second only. So this is very important. So these are the libraries, NumPy, Pandas, date time also. Date time is also needed because date and time, you know, it is for stock price, it is very necessary to have a time or particular date, and then matplotlib. And these are certain, you know, seaborns for, you know, drawing histograms and other graphs. These libraries are used. So let me click it. Yeah, now it is executed. Now we will take a data from SAP underscore stock, and we will store it in URL. So you can see here there must be a data set with the name of URL. URL. Okay, you may search. Not URL. There must be a data with the name of SAP. Let's say this one, SAP stock. So we named it with URL. We give it a name URL. Now we will open it with the pandas and rename it with data. So once I run this, now it is data. Now if you want to see the data set, so you can simply, you know, write here data. Simply you have to write the data name. That's it, and you have to play. You can see this is the data where it is date open high. Means this is a open of open means the opening price of that particular stock, then high low means how high it move that stock price and how low in a particular day, and then closing time, then changes traded volume, turnover, last price of a day, daily traded unit and daily turnover. These are the, you know, certain information of the data, and this is a data of, you know, 2550 rows. It means total of 2550 rows are there. So this is the total data. Now we will see the info. With the info you can see, you know, the all the headers with the values, how many values they have. They have 2550 non-null values, and there are 2550 total rows. It means all having the date, there is date in all the, you know, data set. But in open, you see here 2242. It means the gap between these two around 250. In open, there are 250, you know, blanks are there, which is null. So in high, there are 2543, which is only 7 blanks are there in high. So when you check the whole data, you know, you can find out these kind of, you know, similarly last price of the data zero non-null. Zero non-null means all the values are null in last price data, and daily traded value all are blank, and daily turnover only 7 are values, all others are, you know, null. I think everybody understand this. So this is data.info is one of the command which is used for to checking whether the values are null or not, or how many, you know, just for to understand data in detail, you can use this command data.info. Now data.describe, this command we already frequently used earlier also. दिस इज़ फॉर चेकिंग द मीडियन मोड क्वार्टाइल परसेंटाइल मैक्सिमम मिनिमम ऑल द वैल्यूज यू कैन यू नो फाइंड आउट विद दिस डाटा डॉट डिस्क्राइब. सो आफ्टर दैट डाटा डॉट कॉलम इज़ वन ऑफ द कमांड. आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू यू नो टू जस्ट रिमाइंड ऑल दीज कमांड्स एंड ऑल यू हैव टू अप्लाई दीज कमांड्स ऑन यूअर डाटा सेट वेन एवर यू आर डूइंग सम मशीन लर्निंग और समथिंग ऑन वर्किंग ऑन सम डाटा सेट. यू शुड हैव टू यू नो अप्लाई ऑल दीज कमांड्स एंड सी वट आर द रिजल्ट कमिंग इन यूअर डाटा सेट. सो हेयर डिस्प्ले फीचर्स इन डाटा सेट जस्ट फीचर्स आर यू नो विल कम टू यू. फीचर्स आर दीज हेडर्स बेसिकली दीज इंडेक्स. आई थिंक द डे बिफोर वन डे इन द लैब आई आस्क यू हाउ टू गेट दिस. So this is by the column you can you know easily get date open high low close change everything you can have here. So similarly now we use the daily closing price close as a value to predict so we can discard the other features. So we discard create a new database with only closing price and date. Okay, now we want a database which have only close and you know the close and price and the date. So let's do this, and once we run this and let us check you know df. Now let me check the df here. So if you want to check the df, so you just write df and enter. So you may have the data set df. You see it now, it has index and the closing values. So only indexing the closing values are there. So if you, now you want to see the data df head, I told you earlier also the head from the head commands, you may have the top 5 data set with you. If you want to see more, you can write it here like 15 data. If you want to see, just write how many data you want to check. Otherwise by default it will show you the top 5. So let me see the 15 top 15 from ranging from 0 to the 14, and then df.info. This is again a very important command, df.info. Through this you can have you know information regarding your data set, what are the null set and what are the how many null values are present. So here in index and close both have 2550 2550. So it means there is no null value is present. You have you know clean data now. Now check for the missing value. If there is a missing value, let's run this. Since there is no missing value, it will show you false, right? If there is any missing value in the data set, it will show you true, right? Now we will apply a linear regression. We already learned linear regression, what exactly it is. So let's you know first of all do the training. For training, you know, we have sklearn through which it get, you know, we import training and testing data split, which will split the data into training and testing. And then we will provide a data training size that is 20%. So this will split the data into 20:80 ratio, right? Now import the sklearn linear regression, okay? Now reshape the data, and this is needed because you know the in PD particularly in the NumPy the data is you know like this in a array. So we have to reshape into so that like in matrix the column is multiplied by the rows. So that is why we have to convert it into row and another into column. So once we run this, we have now X train and Y train with us. So before doing this, you can see the X train and Y train, and I'll advise you after running this, you can also check X train and Y train again. You can understand the difference very easily. Now model linear regression and model fit. By doing so, the model is now fitted. Now if you want to see the slope and the intercept, let's run this. You have you know slope of 0.27, that is what we call gradient also, and the intercept is 25.690. So intercept is the value of basically value of the c in the line. So once you have this, you can plot the graph also. By plotting this, you just see this is done through SNS library that we package already we have taken in, at the top. So you can see there are predicted price and the actual price. So actual price is like this, and predicted price is the regression line that you plotted. So you see it is go through the middle of all the data which is already available, which is the actual data. So actual price and the predicted price is this. So why it is necessary? See, our model with the help of, now you have to understand two things. One is Python, another is machine learning. See, you can draw this line with the help of Python also, with the help of Python and with the help of machine learning also. Now what is the difference? The difference is that in Python, when you run the particular code, it is run, it is run only and then destroy. But in the machine learning, what will happen? When you run a code, it will give you a result, and the result is stored back into the machine. So that's, how your data get enriched every time, and your data is updated every time. So here, what has happened? The stock price and date. With the stock price and the date, this is the data line you have. इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि अगर हमारे पास डेट कोई पर्टिकुलर डेट है, उस पर्टिकुलर डेट पे स्टॉक प्राइस कोई इतना था, तो इस ट्रेंड से आपको ये पता लग रहा है कि जैसे ये डाटा, एक्चुअल डाटा ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है, तो व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट मूव. जैसे ये अगर ये नीचे आता है, तो नीचे आने के बाद एक लो को पकड़ता है, उसके बाद वापस ऊपर की तरफ जाता है. तो बाय ऑब्जर्विंग दिस, यू कैन मशीन कैन प्रिडिक्ट द नेक्स्ट मूव. मीन्स मशीन का प्रिडिक्ट होगा वो ऊपर होगा कि नीचे आएगा, बाय सीइंग दिस पैटर्न, बाय द पास्ट पैटर्न. दिस हाउ द स्टॉक प्राइस इज प्रिडिक्टेड. बट अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू, इट इज़ नॉट 100% एक्यूरेट. इट इज़ 90% और 99% एक्यूरेट, बट इट इज़ नॉट 100% एक्यूरेट. दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो दिस इज़ द प्रिडिक्शन. नाउ यू वॉन्ट टू सी द प्रिडिक्शन, यू आर पुटिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ द एक्स टेस्ट हेयर, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू चेक अगेन द डाटा सेट एंड इंडेक्सेस, यू मे हैव अनदर predicted data like this. So the whole thing that I would like to explain here, although this is further, you can find out the RMS values, root mean square values, absolute error, these values you can calculate it now, and accuracy also, the coefficient of accuracy, these values you can calculate. And this is the very important variance score. In this case it is 93%. It means this machine is 93% accurate, and there is 7% ambiguity still in this kind of data set. So this is how you can do the linear regression on a simple data set that I show you. I'll request you all to do the same thing, on the same data set. I will share this data set with you all on your teams, and there is a request, you all should have to run it once. And not only this, I request you to just change the data set and run the same command, so that you can have a complete you have a idea how to do the machine learning, simple linear regression on the data set. I think everybody understand this. If anybody have any questions, you may ask me.